Hey folks, it's JP
and Emil.
We're in New Orleans, we're removing bees. Hopefully they're in between a boarded up window and the window itself. We got a 50 foot lift, they're about a good 30 feet or so up. We got a nice day, it's a bluebird day, it's a little breezy. Hopefully the bees will be nice and cooperative as well. So hope y'all enjoy it. Here's our lift, okay, it's a tow behind. And I used one similar last year. Show you where our bees are. Not there. Not there. That one right there, that boarded up window. We're not certain our bees are entirely behind the plywood. They may be going into the brick, which could pose a dilemma for us. But we don't know until we remove this piece of plywood. Hello, hives. Check it out, folks. Look at that, folks. Is this crazy or what? Man, there's a lot of bees, huh? A lot of everything. Way up there, folks. They're a little bit pissed. All right, this is M. Hood, Mark Hood. He's seen some of the videos on YouTube that we've done, and he happened to come on by while we're doing this one. And
yeah, I'm on my way to get ice.
All right, Mark, we'll let you run, man. Have a good one. This is M. Hood.
M. Hood. Woo!
Check this out, folks. There's some single thickness comb up here, and there's a double comb layer down here. A good bit of bees, and they have some honey stores, obviously. I'm up here, I'm gonna bag them so bees get our numbers down. Maybe they'll get a little bit nicer. They're kind of quite pissy. Pretty high. Just beautiful looking configuration on this window. And you can see the brood comb, some of the brood comb now. Cat worker brood. Some drone brood, bunch of pollen. I mean, just a beautiful setup. And I'm using my new Bushkill bee vac down there. A Robo, a bee master. I sure like it so far. We have it set up with a deep and a medium. Isn't that beautiful, folks? This is our obstacle, this wire right here. What we do, we're going up and over the wire so we can get to our hive. We vacuumed a bunch of bees with the RoboVac. Rob's designed the Bushkill bee vac. It's working like a charm. And we're gonna vacuum some more. We're gonna start getting into this thing. It's gonna be one messy situation, folks. I guarantee you that. But it's a beautiful thing. It's unique, you know? We took this plywood off, folks. We thought literally that they had screwed the plywood into the window frame, but we thought they had used an adhesive, and it was just propolis. So it's like removing a gigantic top cover. What it was like. All right, we're making a little progress. We're starting to take some of this brood out. You can see all the honey we have. I'm gonna save that till last. We don't have honey dripping everywhere. I mean, it's going to be dripping everywhere as it is. So look what they did up here, folks. The window's not completely covered. Emil and I were just talking about it. And I think what they decided was these little gaps here or there, basically that's bee space that they left purposely so that they could travel between the window and the cone so they can get around. If you think about it, it makes a lot of sense. If they just attached a solid cone, they wouldn't be able to travel back there. That's pretty cool how they did that, little architects. See all the chicken feed right here, folks? Up from the chicken feed. Room brew. So two chicken.
I eat it sometimes.
I'm in headed to pancakes. All right, folks, we got our numbers way down. And we're feeling brave, feeling our oats a little bit, pulling back our veils a little bit. They seem to calm down somewhat. Because there's hardly any bees left.
50 that are left.
But anyway, this is where we are. We've got a bunch of brood come out. Let's say we've secured about 7 frames. All right, folks. Making even further progress. There's got to be back there, huh?
I mean, there's still quite a few back there.
Yeah, unless we vacuum them up. I don't know. Well, I see them over here now. Good bit.
There's holes in the middle, and I'm seeing these.
Yeah, it is a good bit, still. Well, it's getting kind of late, folks. It's probably like about 5 o'clock, I guess. We got all the brood comb out. We think she might be in the brood box. Maybe we shook her in there and didn't see her. Or we vacuumed her up, because we're not really seeing any signs that she was up there. So we're going to go through the box right now and see if we can't find her. All the comb is off the window, except for the stuff we got to scrape. This is a windowsill, looking pretty nasty. Honey there, honey in that bag. Honey down there, 2 other bags, bucket full. This is what we got left here. So we're trying to get it done, folks. Not bad for 2 coon asses, huh? Here's the finished product, folks. Wood's put back. Wood is caulked and sealed between the brick and the plywood so they can't get back in the window void space where they were. All right, folks, well, I hope y'all enjoyed the video. It was a tough one. Took a bunch of stinks, got a bunch of brood out, bunch of bees, tons of honey. These weren't hurting. Another video brought to you by JP the Bee Man
and Emil.
And y'all have